Hello everyone, in this video we are taking a look at how we can reset our Medusa 2.0 database. I've got some questions from some users how to do this, and sometimes I would answer that the simplest way is to just spin up the deploy template again, because during the initial deploy the database is seeded and you'll get a fresh database. But what if you have spent a lot of time making customizations to your storefront? What if you have set up plugins in your backend and configured them and you want to keep those around, but you want to scrap your database and start over? So I have a project right here with a backend and a database, and I'm logged into my admin user. And let's just mess around with the data here. So I'm accidentally deleting all the demo products that I still want to keep around. Now they're all deleted. And we'll head over to our storefront here and go to the store and whoop, no products. But this was a mistake and we want to undo that mistake. So I'll head back to Railway, and it's actually extremely simple because we're using the Medusa 2.0 boilerplate. There is a mechanism in the backend that will automatically reseed the database once we connect to one that has not been seeded. So this database is the one that we just messed up with. And to mess it up even further, I'm going to go into the find a user table. And I'll delete the admin user. So here's the admin user and I'll delete it. So if I head back to my backend now and refresh, we are in big trouble. We cannot log into our admin user anymore. And there will be no way to fix our missing products from the admin experience. So we need a new database. So the first thing I want to do is rename the database that is messed up so I can identify it. I'll call it Postgres failed. And I'll move it a little bit to the side here. Then I hit the create button, database, Postgres. And this will take just a few seconds. Put into our canvas and I'll move it down here. That's where I like it to be. And this one is now just called Postgres and this is called Postgres failed. So you see our backend is still pointing an arrow to the failed database and we wanted to point it to the new one. So let's head over to our backend and go into variables and database URL. We want to edit it. And let's just start deleting until we see our new database. This is still the failed Postgres dot database public URL. And we hit save. And we see now that the arrow have switched from the failed one to the new one, but it's purple. So it means that the change still needs to be deployed. Let's hit deploy. Let's open up the backend here and take a look at the logs. And we should be in the deploy phase now. Yeah, now we are in deploy phase. And you see here, it called a script seed once and it checked if the database is seeded, and it was not. So it's going to seed it again. And this is a mechanism that is implemented in the Medusa 2.0 plus storefront template on Railway. It is not implemented by default in Medusa.js. So I'll make sure to leave a link to this template in the video description if you want to use that. Alternatively, you can replicate it by simply going into the boilerplate and take a look at the backend and script. And here's the seed one script that fixes all the database seeding, and you can copy that and implement it in your own project if you want. The series of commands that it run in order to seed the database is npx medusa migrations run and followed by medusa link sync and then npm run seed. And then after these three commands have been run, the database is seeded. But this happens automatically in this template, so you don't have to worry about it. All right, it's finished deploying and we now have a fresh database and we still have our old failed database around. Let's go over to our backend and we need some credentials to log in. So I'll go to variables and copy the email. And I will also copy the password here. And there we have it. We now have our demo products back, and we can go back into the settings and to users and see that we have our admin user as well. All right, in the storefront, if I refresh, we will still not see the products, and that's because we need to trigger a redeploy of the storefront. So when the storefront builds, it pings the backend and asks for all the products, and then it builds up all the pages based on the products that the backend is serving. So if we redeploy the storefront, we should get our products back. I'll pause the video. This was really quick. It took just 38 seconds. Let's head back to our storefront and refresh. And we now have all our products back. So I hope that that gives you an idea about how you can manage your database in Medusa 2.0 on Railway. You can not only create a completely new database if you want to start over, but you can also use this to have experimental databases. You can have as many as you want. So the failed one, I'll delete it, but you could keep it around if you have some data, maybe product data in it or some customer data that you want to keep around and eventually migrate to your final one. So this is a really good way to be able to experiment with your configuration and setup. You can create a new database, connect to it, and then you can always connect back to another one, switch between a development and a production database. All right, that concludes this video. If you have any questions or comments, you may leave them down below. Bye.